Hey there. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to play an easy guitar song, I Just Want to Be Your Teddy Bear. That's originally sung by Elvis Presley. Let's do it.
Oh, baby, let me be your loving teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and meet me anywhere. Oh, let me be your teddy bear. I don't want to be a tiger, cause tigers play too rough. I don't want to be a lion, cause lions ain't the kind you love enough. I just want to be your teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and meet me anywhere. Teddy bear.
Hi there, I'm Tomas Michaud from Real Guitar Success. Teddy Bear is a great song both for students and experienced guitar players. It's one of those easy guitar songs that is fairly easy to play, but is very recognizable. We're going to use just three chords, and I'll show you both an easy way and a little more advanced way. Then I'll go ahead and show you a strumming pattern, and we'll put it all together. Let's start with the chords. The first chord, we're using a folk-style C chord. This is kind of the traditional way of playing a C chord. I have a few versions, but this is very common. You put your first finger on the second string, first fret, second finger over here on the fourth string, second fret, and finally the third string on the third fret of the fifth string. That's roughly the bass note. Though if you hit this low E, the sixth string, it works fine too. Then we've got an F chord. The F chord I'm going to play is this version. Now, if you're just starting out, you may want to try and play it without a bar, and it sounds pretty good. To do that, from the C chord, you put your pinky down next to the third finger on the fourth string, third fret, move the second finger over one string to the third string, second fret, and then leave your first finger here. Now, that's an F chord. The first string now is not a part of it, so I'm going to angle my first finger down a little bit so it deadens out. Now it sounds fine. I'm actually even slightly touching the sixth string with my third finger right here, and that deadens that out too. If you're up for a little more challenge, a good way to do this is to make a partial bar with your first finger, and that will allow you to play the first string as well. Still, I'm deadening out that sixth string. And then if you've been playing for a while and you know your bar chords, or at least can play them and you want to work on them, go ahead and from this position, bar across the first fret. Either way, it's an easy transition from C. You'll notice from C, I just put my pinky down, move the second finger over, and I either flatten this out or make a full bar. Or if just starting out, I leave it there and just angle it down slightly. And then finally, we have a G chord, and I'm going to use this version of G because it's easy for me to change from this C chord to this G. It does involve the pinky. And if that's hard for you, you may want to go ahead and switch your fingers around and either do a version like this, or I often play the G chord like this. I use both my third and pinky, and by putting a third finger there, it gives the pinky support. But for me, the ease of switching from here to here is worth having the pinky alone there by itself. Now, just a little bit about the form of the song. This is a fairly standard song form. It's actually 12 bars. That's the same thing as measures. This 12-bar pattern originally came from blues, but I realize this doesn't sound like blues. That's because it has a different combination of a rhythm pattern and a chord progression. Let's just map out the basic chord progression. We're going to do 4 bars of C, 3 bars of F, and then 1 bar of C. That makes up 8 bars. Then we'll do 2 bars of G and 2 bars of C. Don't worry if you don't remember all that. We're going to go through it. Let's just call a bar for now 4 beats. 4 strums. Each strum will be 1 beat. Let's map it out together. Start with your C chord and try playing along with me. 1, 2, ready, hit it. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 1 measure. 1, 2, 3, 2 measures. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 measures and 1, 2, 3, 4 and 4 measures. Let's do it again, but this time I'm going to add the words so you can hear how the words fit with the chords. Here we go. 1, 2, start with C. Now, baby, let me be again. your loving teddy bear. Last measure to go on to F. Put a chain around my neck again and lead me any C. Where just let me G. Back to C. 1, 2, 3, 4. One more measure. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then that's the verse. It would start over, or you'd go into the chorus, depending on which part of the song you're at. Now, I'm going to go through the chorus in the same way. I'll start with the F chord. Here we go. 1, 2, ready, play. Don't wanna be a G tiger. F, cause tigers play to G. Rug. Back to F. I don't wanna be a tiger lion. Back to F. Lion ain't the kind. G. Going to C at the end. And back in the verse. I just wanna be. And start over again. Now for the strum. We'll start off with a basic strum. It's down, down, up, down, up, down, up. And then I'll show you a little more advanced version. Go ahead and make a C chord and let's try it together. I'll count it out. 1, 2, ready, hit it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, that strum will work fine if you're just learning the song and you're new to guitar. But if you want to add a little pizzazz to it, we can alternate low strings and high strings to add a little motion to it. Now, just to be clear, you don't have to stick to the exact same way I'm doing it, but you can experiment and see what sounds good to you. Also, I made a whole video on these kind of techniques for strumming, and I'll put a link to that. Here we go. 1, 2, ready, hit it. So here's the exact pattern I'm doing. I'm going low, down, high, high, then low, high, 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 low, high, high, low, high, high, high. Now, the one other thing I'm doing, just so if you want to experiment with it, I'm adding a little accent on beats 2 and 4. That means I'm putting just a little extra push. Nothing exaggerated. In fact, you have to listen closely, but you can feel it. It gives a little drive to it. Listen. Here's the basic strum. Now here's with the low and highs and that accent. 1, 2, 3. Okay, now we're gonna put it all together. I'm gonna play the song once through and I encourage you to play along with me. Now, if you want, you're not ready for that, you can just listen and then go back and try it afterwards. Also, please use the strum that you're comfortable with right now, whether it's that very first strum or adding some of the techniques. You can always add to it. But if you're trying to do too many things at once, it's gonna be hard to actually follow along with me. Here we go.
Baby. Loving teddy bear, gonna F. Put a chain around my neck and lead me back to sea. And where will it be? Your teddy bear. Go to the chorus. I don't wanna be a tiger, cause tigers play too rough. I don't wanna be a lion, a lion they behind you. Love a man. Just wanna be your teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be, oh, let me be your teddy bear. Verse 3. Oh, baby, let me be around you every night. Gonna run your fingers through my head and cuddle me. Oh, let me be, oh, let me be your teddy bear. Back to the chorus. I don't wanna be a tiger, cause tigers play too rough. I don't wanna be a lion, cause lions ain't the kind you love enough. I just wanna be.
That's the second verse.
Your teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck and leave me anywhere. Oh, let me be. Oh, let me be. Your teddy bear. Oh, let me be. Oh, let me be. Your teddy bear. I just wanna be your teddy bear.
So that's it for today's lesson. Did you learn something? If you did, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. And if you want exclusive lessons and tips, go over to my website at thomasmichaud.com and subscribe to my newsletter. It's free. Now, I want to turn it over to you. Which form of the F chord are you going to use? Are you going to try the F chord that looks a lot like the C chord? Or are you going to go ahead and use this mini bar here or the full bar? And how about that strum? Are you going to go for the simplest version of the strum? Are you going to try and add some of those techniques, the low, high, and the accents on 2 and 4? Let me know in the comments below right now.